In order to calculate somebody's age, you need two dates to work with, the current date and their date of birth. Now, there's a few ways to get the current date into a cell. The first is you could type it. The second is you can use a keyboard shortcut, which is Control Semicolon. That's a shortcut to put today's date into a cell, but it's a static date. And what that means is, at the time of recording, we're looking at the 18th of May here. If I came in tomorrow and looked at this cell, it would still say the 18th of May. As a comparison, you can use a function, which is equals today, open and close brackets. This will also give you the 18th of May, the current date. But the difference being, when I come in tomorrow, that's going to say the 19th of May, and the day after, the 20th of May, and so on. So when you're working out somebody's age, you need to make sure you use the today function, because that always gives you a current date to work with, and as they get older, the age increments. Now behind every date, there's actually a number. Dates are stored as numbers in Excel. And that's good, because it removes all the complications with date calculations. Like for example, different months have different number of days. So some have 30, some have 31. February has 28, unless it's a leap year, in which case it has 29. In a year, there's 365 and a quarter days to work with. That's not an easy number to work with. Okay, so the fact that dates are stored as numbers makes your life easier. It's a good thing. Now, to see the number behind these two dates, as an example, if I select both the dates and click the comma, that's the simplest way to convert to a number, you can see we're currently 43,238. That is the number of days after the 1st of January 1900, which is day one. Now, the 2nd of January 1900, that's day two. 3rd of January 1900, that's day three. So every day since that very first day, they increment the number by one. And we're currently at 43,000 and a few. So that's just to show you. Let me delete those. And let's use that information to go and calculate the age for Bob. Now, there's actually two steps to the process. We're going to take today's date, subtract his date of birth, which will actually give us the number of days between the two dates, which is how many days old he is. We're then going to divide by 365 and a quarter to calculate his age in years. So here's the process. I'm going to start off with equals today, open and close bracket, minus his date of birth. Now that's stage one. If I press enter at this point, it actually gives us a date format for our result because we're adjacent to a date cell. So if I take this column here and I convert to a number, it shows us 20,771. That's how many days old Bob is. Now, to get this into a number of years, I modify the formula by first of all putting what you've already done into brackets, so it gets calculated first, and then divide by 365 and a quarter. That's the number of days in a year. And when we press enter this time, we get his age in years. Now, if I copy this down all the way down, you can see that it's calculated everybody's age down to how many decimal places you decide to show. So if I show more decimal places here, you know, it goes right down. So there's lots of detail here if you needed it. Now actually, what we need for somebody's age is just the whole number section of that number. We don't need anything after the decimal point. Now, what we can't do, and this is a mistake some people make, is adjust the number of decimal places on the displayed format. Now just watch what happens on the first one here if I try and do that. So 56.86 years old. So if I decrease the decimal places down, at this point here where it's still got one decimal place, it's still got the correct age, 56.9. But as soon as I reduce down to a whole number, that 56.9 jumps up to 57. Now, he's not 57 yet. He's 57 when his birthday comes around. So you can't do that to somebody's age. It just doesn't work. So what you need to do is to actually modify the value using a function. Now, there's actually three ways you can do this. You can use a round down function, you can use a floor function, and you can use a trunk function. Okay, let's tackle each of those in turn. So let's come across here. Now, just working with Bob's age as an example, if I say equals round down, I can use the age result and say round down to no decimal places. And what this does is it goes down to 56.00. And of course, if I adjust this figure and use the tools at the top here to only show no decimal places, it still shows 56, which is good. Now, the second approach is to use the floor function. Now, the way this works is you write equals floor, open the brackets, select the age with all its decimal places, and you say round down to the nearest multiple of 1, as in the nearest whole number downwards. And that's what floor does. And when you press enter, again you get 56.00, and if you adjust the display of this down to a whole number, it still shows 56. The last function you can use is what's called a trunc function, T-R-U-N-C. It's short for truncate. And here, you provide the number, and you say at what point you want to truncate anything to the right. So if we say 0, which means at the decimal point, no decimal places, it truncates everything after the decimal point and just leaves the whole number. So that will also give you 56, And again, if you trim this down display-wise, it shows 56 still. So to apply any one of these to our calculations over in column C, you just wrap the whole thing inside any one of those. So let's say we do the trunk function as one example here. We say equals trunk, open the brackets, we provide all of that as the thing we're working with, and we say comma zero. Close the brackets at the end and press enter. And if we copy this all the way down, we'll get our results showing as 0.000. And if we then modify the display, it shows the correct age all the way down. So that's the approach you need to take. You need to first of all understand how the calculation works, the fact that dates are stored as numbers, and you can just take one away from the other and divide by the number of days in a year. And by the way, the reason we use the 0.25 instead of just 365 is the quarter is important. Generally, we just use 365 as the number of days in a year, and then once every 4 years, we add the four quarters together to get the leap year. But in your calculation, you need to include it, because let's say you take someone that's 40 years old and you missed off the quarter in your calculation, that's 40 quarters, which is 10 days. And if your calculation's out by 10 days, that's quite a big error. So don't fall into that trap. Make sure you put the 365.25 into your calculation and you will remain accurate.